I am a senior lecturer in zoology. My name is Yakesh. 18 years experience in various corporate colleges, Sri Chaitanya, Narayana, and Nalanda junior colleges. In Vijayawada, Vizag, and Anantapur. Anyhow, today we are discussing about the introduction of intermediate first year zoology class. So, discussing about the zoology. Right? Zoology. So, this zoology is one of the subjects in the intermediate BIPC group. So, you are all BIPC students, right? BIPC group means biology, physics, and chemistry. Actually, this biology contains two subjects. One is botany and another one is zoology. So, I am a zoology lecturer. I can deal the zoology. So, this zoology is one of the branch of biology. So, this zoology is one of the branch of biology. Actually, biology is one of the subjects in your previous 10th class also studied as the biological science or natural science as NS, right? Actually, the BIPC students are very much interested in the biology, right? That's why we are all selecting the BIPC group, especially interested in biology. So, this biology contains two subjects. One is botany and another one is zoology. So, botany is discussed in the botany lecture class. Now you are discussing about the zoology as in the zoology lecture. So, this biology is a very much interesting topic in our daily life. In our daily life, we are very applied application of ourselves as in the human body. So, this biology already you are studying in the 10th class, right? So, what is meant by biology? What is meant by biology? Biology means study of living organisms. Study of living organisms, right? Living organisms means the organisms possess the life. So, these living organisms furtherly major classified into two types. One is plants and another one is animals. Basically, these living organisms are classified into two types. One is plants and another one is animals, right? So, the study of plants is called as botany. Study of plants is called as botany. Then study of animals is called as zoology. Zoology. right? So this botany is one of the subject, zoology is another subject. So these two subjects in your YPC group as the botany, zoology, along with the physics and chemistry, right? So in your previous knowledge of biology, right? So this biology contains two Greek terms. Biology contains how many Greek terms? Two Greek terms. One is bios and another one is logi. Bios and logi. Bio means life or living organisms. Bio means life or living organisms. Logi means study. Logi means study. That means biology means study of life or study of living organisms. Study of living organisms as the plants and animals. Both plants and animals are studied in the biology in the 10th class syllabus, right? Biology. So this biology term was first coined by the scientist name called J.B. Lamarck, Jean Baptiste Lamarck. He was one of the French biologists. So he was coined the term biology. Who coined the term biology? J.B. Lamarck. And this biology is first studied and explained and researched on the biology by the scientist name called Aristotle. The Aristotle was first studied and explained and researched on the biology. That's why the Aristotle was considered as the father of biology. Who is father of biology? Aristotle was considered as the father of biology. So this is about the introduction of biology. Biology means study of life or study of living organisms. And these living organisms are majorly classified into the two types. One is plants and another one is animals, right? So whenever the study of plants is known as botany, the study of animals is called as zoology. So these are the two subjects in our YPC group. One is botany and another one is zoology. First, biology term was first coined by the scientist name called J.B. Lamarck, Jean Baptiste Lamarck. He was one of the French biologists. And Aristotle was first studied and explained and researched on the biology. That's why this Aristotle was considered as the father of biology. So, this biology contains two subjects. One is botany and another one is zoology. Is basically. However, these living organisms are further classified into the plants and animals, and also where there are microorganisms. Along with the plants and animals, The other living organisms are microorganisms. Whenever study about the microorganisms is called as microbiology. But microbiology is studied in the degree level, in the BSc level. But in our intermediate, will be studied two subjects only, as one is botany and another one is zoology. Then another type of microorganisms will be studied as the subject called microbiology. You know very well about the plants. In our living world, we can observe so many plants. Now, whenever the study about the plants is called as botany. In our living world, we can observe so many animals. Right? So many animals, from ants to elephants. Several animals are observing in our daily life. Several plants will be observing in our daily life. That's why whenever the study of plants is called as botany, and the study of animals is called as zoology. And also, the third type of living organisms are microorganisms. Now, these microorganisms are studied in the subject called microbiology. Here, micro means smaller. The smaller organisms. That's why which are observed under the microscope only. What are the examples for microorganisms? Like bacteria, viruses. The microscopic organisms. Protozoans are the microscopic organisms. Like protozoan, parasite, which can cause the diseases. Bacteria can cause the diseases. Viruses can cause the diseases. So many viral diseases are there. So many bacterial diseases are there. So many protozoan parasitic diseases are there. Several other parasitic diseases are there. All the diseases causing organisms will be studied in the microbiology. Actually, nowadays we are suffering from coronavirus, as the disease called COVID-19, a very dangerous disease in our world. So many people faced the effect of coronavirus, and leads to death also. Entire world the fearing disease, the viral disease, the corona. And this corona is one of the virus. Corona disease is caused by the virus, COVID. And this coronavirus will be studied in the microbiology. That's why this biology knowledge very useful to us. Biology knowledge is very useful to us. To study of microorganisms. Actually, these microorganisms are not observed in our naked eye. Only observed under the microscope. The microscopic organisms. Like bacteria, viruses, and protozoan parasites. So, this is about the living organisms. Before the learning about the zoology, you are learning about biology. Due to the cause of zoology is one of the part of biology. Now we are discussing about the zoology. Earlier we have discussed about the zoology. Zoology is one of the part of biology. Right? So, this zoology is also contains two Greek terms. One is zoo, another word is lazy. Two Greek terms. One is zoo, another one is lazy. Two terms. So they're called zoology. Right? So in here, zoo means animal. Lazy means study. That means zoology is study of animals. That's why it is also called as animal science. Animal science. Science means knowledge. Knowledge. The way there is a zoology to know about the knowledge of animals as the animal science. Animal science. Right? So, this animal science, which can explain about the various aspects of the animals. Various aspects of the animals. Various aspects. Various processes of animals. As in the one of the living organisms. Animal is one of the living organisms. Actually, this animal is different from the plants. What are the major difference between plants and animals? The plants are fixed, but animals are can move from one place to another place. Whenever the animal can move from one place to another place as the locomotion will be observed in the animals, but not observed in the plants. Right? Another several phenomenon will be different in the plants and animals. So, now we are discussing about the animal science. Right? Here, zoology. Zoology contains two Greek terms. One is zoo, another one is lozy. Here, zoo. Already, hear the word zoo as the zoo park, zoological park. Zoo park. Zoological park like present in Hyderabad, Vizag and other cities. What is observed in the zoo park? Can observe the animals. The zoo park can observe the animals. Especially which type of animals are present in the zoo park? As the wild animals. Then these wild animals are taken out from their wild habitats in the forest. But taken into the specialized particular area and which are protected in the special area called zoological park. Very much interesting, can observe the zoological park in the various animals. Animals means what are the examples for animals? Several types of birds. Very interesting about the birds. Observing the several types of fishes, several types of frogs, several types of snakes, several types of lizards, several types of mammals. So all these are studied in the zoology. In the animals, the zoology can study from the multicellular animals. Multicellular animal means, multi means many. The animal body is made up of many cells. So these multicellular animals are termed as metazoa. 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 In here zoa, zoo, zoa means animals. Meta means multi. The multicellular animals are included in the kingdom Metazoa. It's also known as Animalia. Animalia is the kingdom. Animalia is the kingdom. Animalia is the kingdom.